Good morning, children. At my location, I do not have access to Zoom, or so I'm trying to look into the other apps wherein which I can connect with you. Till then, I plan to take up page-wise explanation of the chapters which we are going to cover in class 10. Today, I'm undertaking class 10 geography. The lesson is agriculture. And the pages which I am going to cover is page number 34 and page number 35. Though there are many concepts of this lesson which you have done in the earlier classes, but this is better that we start off with the revision of the previous classes and then slowly moving on to the different level in this chapter. Alright, to begin with, first we all know that India is an agro-based economy. Right from the first year plan initiated by our first Prime Minister Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru to this day, first 5 year plan which began in the year 1950, to this day, India is assumed to be as an agro-based economy. The reason for this is because we have high dependency on agriculture. There are many industries in India which depend on the raw material coming in from agriculture, which are called the agro-based industries. Moving on to what the lesson says, starting from page number 34, 2/3 of India's population is engaged in agriculture. Well, we all know the agricultural laborers, farmers. We studied in the previous classes that people engage themselves in activities, jisko hum normal bhasha mein we call it as farming, cultivation, agriculture. These are all synonymous to the activity of producing crops from the soil depending upon its fertility, amount of rainfall, environmental conditions, etc. We know that agriculture is a primary activity. Well, you have studied three kinds of activities: the primary activity, the secondary activity, and the tertiary activity. Primary activity is agriculture, secondary activity is manufacturing, and tertiary is service providing. So we are not studying about the other two aspects, but we are taking on simply agriculture in this lesson. We know that the agriculture provides raw material to agro-based industries. Let's talk about, let's say, sugar industry, the jute industry, the rubber industry, etc. The count is ongoing. Alright, so we know that it is all these industries that take material, raw material from agriculture are called the agro-based industries. Other than this, other than the normal food that we eat, we all know that food is grown in the fields through the process of agriculture. Other than this, there are certain new concepts which we have been hearing about in the past few years. It's called the cash crops. The concept of cash crop is when we grow one kind of crop over a big piece of land, basically for selling it. The purpose of growing cash crops is only and only commercial. We grow the crop, we sell the crop, and there is no eating the crop process involved in cash crops. It is only raw material for agro-based industries. The only purpose is selling, profit yielding. That's all. Alright, we are still on page number 34 only, and coming on to the next paragraph on page number 34, it talks about what are the factors which influence cultivation or farming. Cultivation and farming are synonymous to each other. So let's go on to the factors. Factors, environment. What kind of environmental conditions do we have? What's the humidity present? What's the kind of vegetation which is there? What is the kind of temperature which exists? Then moving on to technology. Technology means how much of implements, how much of new technology we can use in agriculture, like threshers, we can use mechanical plows, tractors, etc. It depends how much our cultivation will increase, depends upon the number of implements of technology that we are able to use in the agricultural sector. Coming on to the next one, which is the socio-cultural factor, it's like how the society is. What are the cultural beliefs of the society? Every society has certain seasons for sowing, certain seasons for harvesting, certain prayers, certain beliefs that they have associated with agriculture. Now moving on, we've been hearing about this word subsistence quite a lot. You should be happy that you are not in a live class, otherwise I would have thrown this question at you as to what is subsistence. If you go back to your previous classes, we have learned that subsistence is growing only as much as one needs, enough for our need, sustaining ourselves. Well, that's all for page number 34 till this board talks off. I'm going to shift the board and come back to you with another video. I'm going to send small videos only so that you have no issue in downloading these videos and I have no issue in uploading these videos. In case of any doubt, please send a voice message, a written message, or make a video of yourself asking me the concept which you haven't understood. Alright, I hope you understand.